It is Wednesday, December 4th. Welcome back to Correct Opinions. It's December. Hope you're all having a nice end of the year. Christmas is in the air. Love is in the air. And I'm still triggered, but another segment of triggered. I'm a TikToker, and we also go over some Christmas music, but not before we break down some unknown fall music. You're going to like this. Correct Opinions is back, baby. Roll music.
Correct Opinions.
Hello, people. How are we doing? It's beautiful. December's here. Had a great week. Hope everyone had a nice Thanksgiving. I had a nice Black Friday sale. Hope you copped some of the merch. It's 30% off. We dropped some new stuff. They're probably still out there. Go check it out. Get your uncles. You know that annoying uncle who always reads his Facebook out loud? Get him a Do Less, God Bless t-shirt. Maybe that'll help. Who knows? But thank y'all for coming on back. We got a great episode today. I have something I think you'll like later in the show. But I hope we're having a nice Thanksgiving. I just got filled with butter and bread for a few days. I'm back. A little bigger. And a little, I wouldn't say better. I don't know if I'm better for it. But that's what it's all about, man. Just pigging out. I went to an NFL game. Went to a Kansas City Chiefs game. Had a great time. Agency I work with gifted me a couple tickets as like an engagement gift. Very nice of them. So we had great tickets. Like 10th row, 50-yard line. It was amazing. I had an issue with the guy behind me. He had me a little... I guess we'll just get right into it. The guy behind me had me a little...
Triggered.
So the Chiefs do this chant, right? That, number one... Every sports team that has some kind of like Native American mascot, which, you know, I'm not going to get into the politics of that, but everyone will do that chant. Oh, oh, Florida State Seminoles, Atlanta Braves, Kansas City Chiefs, list goes on. Oh, oh. So when the whole crowd's doing it, you know, it sounds cool. It's like this war chant. The guy behind me thought he was in 11th grade choir class. Oh, 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 oh. I'm not, no exaggeration. That was what he was doing. Directly behind me. Oh, oh, oh. He would like bounce on the last note and then do this obnoxious vibrato. Oh, 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 oh. I turned around and looked. You know, I did one of those, like, I got to see this guy for myself. We're at a football game. 10th row. It's intense. It's cold. The guy to my left had on, like work overalls and a huge beard. He was like, yeah, I need more beer. He was like that. And the guy behind me, oh, oh. I was like, read the room. Read the stadium. It's like, and pass over the middle. Boom! He's decleated, incomplete. Oh, oh, oh! It just ruins the whole vibe. It's a chant the fans do. It's a football game. It's intense. Oh, oh! Everyone's yelling, shouting, and the field goal is up. No good. The kicker gets absolutely. His head gets taken off. Yeah! The guy behind me. Yes, go Chiefs. But it was fun. I went with my fiance because it was a gift. She'd never been to an NFL game. She's definitely the type of woman who couldn't care less about sports, but she's like, yeah, let's go. It'll be fun. I remember late in the second quarter, the opposing team missed a field goal, so the whole crowd cheered. And she looks at me and goes, why is everyone cheering? I said, what do you mean? He just missed a field goal. She's like, oh, I missed that. I wasn't paying attention. What? We're on the 10th row. It's right there. What else is happening that just distracted you? Like, you had to darn near be turned around. What could have distracted you? Maybe the singing guy behind us, but That was great. Wait, what just... Oh, I missed that. I missed... Wait, they just kicked a field goal? I wasn't paying attention. Well, I'm glad you're having... Glad you're really getting into the spirit here. Rooting on the people. Oh, 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 shut up. I couldn't believe that, man. He was singing... You ever go to church and there's like a woman behind you? Well, there's like... You know, that, I mean, you can sing however you want, but you really can't. You know, it's like... You got to do less to some degree. Just some like choral woman behind you. Our God is an awesome God. We read from heaven above. It's like, I can't concentrate. You sound like a bird in Mary Poppins. Are you in Snow White or are we? Jeez, you're putting in the white and Snow White. Please.
I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God.
It's just not even on pitch.
Oh, oh, oh.
Brutal. Brutal. But I also went to a family gathering of sorts, kind of a family reunion. And so as those are, I didn't know everyone there. Why are we hanging out with these people? They're family. They're strangers. If this qualifies as family, then my dentist I see annually is now my cousin. I mean, what qualifies? I see him once a year, man. Same with my dermatologist for my checkup. Hey, dermatologist, love you. You're my family now, I guess. What? But there's this little cute little like 10-year-old cousin who I didn't really know. And she was freaking out because she follows me on TikTok. So I'm a TikToker, number one. Number two, at family reunions, people are more likely to know you from TikTok than from actually being related to you. That's what we learned. So, but really, I looked, this cute little girl, she blessed. I follow you on TikTok. Isn't that great? I'm a TikToker, man. You didn't know that. If you know what TikTok is, are you living under a rock or you're 25 and up? But TikTok is the new social media app for all the kids. Number one, 10-year-old on with a phone. That's terrifying. I think if I had access to a phone at 10, I would probably be committing crimes. It wouldn't have been good. But anyway, she's like, oh, it's just crazy because most of you listening probably, all the people who follow me, my age, older, 20s, 30s, 40s. But TikTok, I got 10-year-olds saying they like my TikToks. It's kind of cute and scary, but hey, it's crazy. There's a lot of horrible stuff on TikTok. You download TikTok, swipe 10 times, and you'll see, I mean, someone's daughter who needs to be in youth group is like shaking her tushy, and you're like, what? Where's your parents? TikTok's wild. It's a wild west of puberty. I don't know, man. If you're a parent, your kid's on TikTok, and you're not checking it out, maybe look into it. Look, I mean, I give a lot of parenting advice on correct opinions. You're welcome. You are welcome. Coffee break. Oh, ooh, that's good stuff. Second coffee of the day. Double shot espresso, man. I'm fired up. Yep, I'm a TikToker. It is a fun app, actually. I just post my same videos on there, but yeah, parenting advice. Check out your kids on TikTok. Yeah. Christmas, we're in full Christmas effect. I'm listening to Christmas music. I got to get Christmas gifts. I had a discussion with my parents. I was like, they're like, what do you want? What do you want? I'm like, do you want me to just like order it on Amazon and ship it to you? Yeah, that'd be great. I'm like, then just don't even wrap it. Do we have to do this? That's what it occurred to me because I'm also trying to do wedding registry. And I don't know if you know how those work. Nowadays, like oh my gosh. A registry is just online, and you before the wedding, you go online and just like click, 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 and it just delivers to them. We need that for Christmas gifts. Hey, go to TreyTreysList.net, and his registry's there. Just pick something out, and he'll get it in a couple business days. That's what we need for Christmas, man. Come on, we're almost in 2020, man. Got to get with the times here. Just send it to me. So when we're together, we can just visit. That's why. Oh, that's sweet. But really, Yeah, I think that seems like a good strategy, because otherwise you get gifts you don't want, or you got to go through the whole thing of like acting like you don't know what's under the wrapper. I don't know. Blech. But I've been listening to Christmas songs. I've been listening to Christmas music. I have strong opinions on Christmas music, but I'm not going to get into that until we look at a real gem of an album a fan sent in. Like I said, I loved seeing y'all suggestions and like stuff you want me to roast. correctopinions@treykennedy.com is the email. Email correctopinions@treykennedy.com for your segment suggestions, etc. Because someone sent this in, and this, I mean, I'm going to show everyone this. So they sent me, they said they want to remain anonymous, respect, but they sent me, they have this woman they know who put out a fall album, because she said, she posted on her Facebook, this artist, if you will, this singer, said, "I'm so excited to announce the release of my autumn album titled Hello Fall." So, because we gotta dive into this before we get full Christmas music, but just bear with me here. This woman says she wrote this album because there's no autumn music out there, and we need something to stop from listening to Christmas music so early. I like the entrepreneur mind here. She has a point. I mean, we could argue there's probably a reason there's no fall music, because that would be insane. But she goes on. She goes, I get so excited for the holidays to start, and this album now makes me most excited to celebrate the autumn season. So someday I hope for it to be totally professionally redone. Michael Bublé. So she's calling for a Bublé cover. We'll see. You never say never. Never. And she goes on. Thank you. Da da da. We had some songs. So this is like an 8-song album. Let's go to the title song. The title track, just simply Hello Fall. These are on YouTube. And this woman, she looks just like me in my fall videos. She's walking through a fall foliage.
Hello, fall, glad to see you here. The leaves on the trees are falling so near.
Cult music.
Leaves are falling, autumn calling. Life starts all over again when it's crisp in the fall.
Life starts all over again when it's crisp in the fall. Jeez, this is the worst thing that's happened since the fall. All right, verse 2.
Good morning, pumpkin, let's fall in love. Pumpkin spice kisses are what I'm dreaming of. I'm falling for fall and sweater wet.
Wait. What, let's listen to that again. What?
Morning, good morning, pumpkin. Let's fall in love. Pumpkin spice kisses are what I'm dreaming of.
Pumpkin, let's fall in love. Pumpkin spice kisses. She wants to make out with a pumpkin. Let's keep listening.
It's fall, y'all. Be filled with thanks and giving. Caramel apples, pumpkin pie. Fall is finally here. Me, oh my.
Me, oh my. There's a nice little harmony there.
Every leaf speaks bliss to me.
Okay, that's Hello Fall.
Caramel apples, me, oh my. I'm gonna find a pumpkin and marry it. All of the leaves are crisp and falling. I want to live inside the pumpkin forever, oh my.
I think that were the lyrics. This is another song off the album titled Finding the Perfect Pumpkin. Let's dive in. Let's just start from the top. Okay. This sounds like the same song, but let's get it.
Today's that day, just once a year, we'll find that round orange holiday cheer. Searching and
that round orange holiday cheer. finding the perfect pumpkin. Just use Tinder, am I right? Sorry.
Pumpkin patch.
I knew that was it coming.
Big ones, small ones, crooked ones and all. This marks the time for finally it's fall. which one, it's so hard to choose.
Mm.
Our carving contest, I cannot lose. Through the patch, all over and around. Pumpkins everywhere, just one to be found.
I'll find it, I'm gonna find it and marry it. Where's the perfect pumpkin? Is it brown? Is it orange? Nothing rhymes with orange. I'm attracted to pumpkins. Let's go on. I think we need it. Favorite pies. Let's see what favorite pies, the track Favorite Pies has got for us. Ooh, we're picking up the flow a little bit.
Hey, pumpkin pies.
Name pie is a special treat. Sharing with friends and the people we meet. A treat we eat the whole year through. In November it's special for me and you. The fall leads to Thanksgiving, when pie is eaten with everything. So many times it's hard to choose.
Woo!
I'll try them all, I've got nothing to lose. I have my favorites, I love the best.
It tell us your favorite.
Each year,
which
each
one's your favorite?
Taste test. My favorite as a child was cherry pie.
Okay.
The next year it changed, don't ask me why. Next it
why?
Was peach, then banana.
Don't leave us hanging.
Then lemon meringue was an absolute dream.
Woo!
The year after that, loved apple pie.
The year after that, I died. 'Cause I ate pie every day. Cherry, lemon, pumpkin, and pecan. It gave me heart disease.
Being my mom, or at least I try.
Okay, hey. All right, how many songs are on this? There are 8. Let's see what the fall to-do list. We got lots to do here. Tell us about it, girl. Oh, this one has an ad on it, so that's this song. We are currently giving this song its 9th view. Isn't that amazing? Thanks for sending this in, Anonymous. This song has 8 views on YouTube. We're giving it 9, baby. What do you got to do? Tell us.
Have yourself.
Right there. I'm impressed she was able to squeeze 8 songs out of this. I mean, she's got to be like, how many different ways can I sing about fall?
Have yourself a fabulous fall.
Know who needs a cameo on this? The guy behind me.
Fabulous fall. Oh.
Break this harvest season. Share gratitude and be thankful. There are fun things we need to complete.
Tell us.
My fall to-do list is the name. I wait all year to do each one.
What are they?
I won't quit until I've completed each one.
The top of my list is to marry a pumpkin.
Okay, I don't know. These are just becoming all of the same. There's a song called Falling Leaves and a song called Autumn Leaves. So let's quickly listen to those and see if they're any different. This is Falling Leaves and Autumn Leaves. They're both playing at the same time. I'm playing 2 songs at once, you can't tell.
Okay. Start falling to the ground.
That's autumn leaves, and what's fall leaves?
Each and every stem, green is where they start. Colors grow and change apart.
That's falling leaves. This is autumn leaves.
I'll cuddle with me autumn crunch.
The autumn crunch. Well, Bublé, your move. Your move, Bublé.
I'm gonna find that autumn crunch when I run away with my favorite pumpkin. I'm gonna turn it into a pie and eat it until I die.
End album. Your move, Bublé. Your move. Oh, man. They're still trying to bump that fall playlist. It's still technically fall, but also Christmas. And before we get into some Christmas song reviews, we got some sponsors. So thank you, BetterHelp and Theragun. BetterHelp, you've heard me talk about it. I'm going to talk about it again. BetterHelp is here to help you. BetterHelp will assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist. The service is available for clients worldwide. There's a broad range of expertise in BetterHelp's counselor network, which may not be locally available in many areas. You'll get timely and thoughtful responses, plus you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions so you won't ever have to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room as with traditional therapy. BetterHelp wants you to start living a happier life today. And for my listeners, you guys get a special offer, 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/Trey. That's BetterHelp, HELP/TREY. And join the over 500,000 people taking charge of their mental health with the help of an experienced professional. I've done counseling. I highly recommend it. It's amazing. And with BetterHelp, you can do it from the comfort of your own home. Affordable. Good stuff. I got you, man. 10% off your first month. BetterHelp.com/Trey. And thank you to Theragun for sponsoring today's episode. Theragun is an easy-to-use handheld device that helps to relieve tension and increase blood flow. Your boy lifts weights. I'm jacked. Believe me, Dan. Believe me, dude. And I have some muscle soreness, and the Theragun, man, it hurts great. You know what I mean? It hurts good. Gets those knots out. I'm serious, dude. I love using it. The Theragun comes with multiple attachments for targeted muscle treatments all over the body. Whether you're an athlete, mom, business professional, fitness enthusiast, or a person who experiences pain. So, everyone. Each Theragun provides a natural approach to improving your physical health and wellness. I like to use mine in the mornings. It's a great way to quickly power up, get the muscles going. Get it fired up, couple of espressos, boom. So sitting down at, you know, for hours at your desk, be hard on the body. So work out those soreness, man. It's awesome. And I have an offer for the listeners today. Okay. So go to theragun.com/opinions and you get two free attachments. That's right. The Theragun comes with all these attachments, you know, a pointy one, a rounded one to get in those knots or get a more like broad rub. You feel me? So if you order now, you'll get two free attachments with your purchase. That's a $40 savings. Go to theragun.com/opinions. So we all know and love Christmas music, and we all know that this is the best Christmas song ever made.
Ooh, Merry Christmas, happy holidays.
Merry Christmas.
Oh yeah, yeah.
We all know. I might just play it in the background the rest of the podcast. In Sync, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. Probably the best Christmas album. This is the best Christmas jam. Hey! You guys know I'm an In Sync guy. Gosh, this is the go-to. I put this on, I just fire it up. That's the best. So that, we're going to, I mean, I would love to hear y'all's opinions, but mine's the correct opinion. But that's my go-to song. You can't forget about, man, I used to bump these guys back in the day. Tell me you know who these people are.
Give it to me, Young Mike.
That sounds weird to say, actually. The Jackson 5?
Santa Claus is coming to town.
I saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus by the Jackson 5.
Wow! Mommy's kissing Santa Claus. Kissing Santa Claus.
The irony.
Wow, Michael's kissing.
Okay, well, it's not. Santa Claus is coming to town. All the kids sit on his lap. And then later, all the kids would sit. Okay, we're going to not. We're going to move on. Sam Smith.
A merry little Christmas.
Sam Smith's voice is so painfully beautiful. Not so, he's sinking. He's Listen to that. He's telling us to have a Merry Christmas. He's telling us to have a happy, joyous day. And listen to how he says. I'm so sad. When do you go back? Hurry, play it. Hurry, play that. Oh, gosh. Oh, that made me so sad. Stop it.
Merry little Christmas.
Be so happy from now on. He's like wailing in sorrow. It just makes me so sad. Christmas music. You could go down the list. The best Christmas music. This, I mean, I'm not one to ever hate on JB, do. Y'all know this jam. Justin Bieber telling us all to get under the mistletoe with him. Scoot over, buddy. JK, what? When did this come out? When was this song released? It was released 2011. It is 2019. He put this out when he's 25. He put this out 9 years ago. Do the math. I'm smart. He was 16 when he put this out. Isn't it weird how our culture works? We're all singing along with this 16-year-old boy. Get under the mistletoe. My nuts roasting like July. But y'all gotta put on that Jay Legend. Oh.
I don't need my stocking filled with toys. But I don't need
toys. I don't need my stocking filled with toys. Chief singer been listening too much Legend. But I will say the best Christmas album. Oh my gosh, you put out another one. Michael Bublé put out. Oh, it's a song. I just can't wait till Bublé starts singing Autumn Leaves and Fall Leaves. Oh boy. I can't wait till he sings this, man. I cannot wait till he's singing.
Hello, fall. Glad to see you here.
Can you imagine Bublé playing that down? Hello, fall. Hello, fall. I'm glad to see you here. That's good stuff. Can't get old on that. I'm going to circle back now. I'm going to circle back to a little bit more of a... Someone sent me an article, which I thought was hilarious. As you guys know, I'm probably not one to be the most sensitive, so let's keep that in mind. What else I do, let's God bless. This came out a few weeks ago by the today.com. There's probably other places. This reads like an Onion, like satirical article, but let's begin. Naomi Pachachik, I don't know the, never mind the last name. Naomi was making dinner when her 10-year-old daughter, Rhythm. So that's already, Naomi was making food when her 10-year-old daughter, Rhythm,
crazy white baby names,
suddenly called over to help with her math homework. Like most parents, this Utah resident, of course they live there, is used to helping her child troubleshoot homework problems. But this time around, Rhythm actually didn't need help solving the equation. She said, Mom, come and read this question. I'm not answering this. This is wrong. While completing her math homework, the fourth grader came across a question that didn't quite sit right with her. It read, the table to the right shows the weight of 3 fourth grade students. How much heavier is Isabel than the lightest student? the issue at hand, you ask? Rhythm was concerned the question was offensive to young girls who might already feel insecure. She circled the question, said, this is offensive and it's rude, spelled R-O-O-D. She's 10. That's fine. So it goes on, yada, yada, yada. And she told the teacher, and, you know, the teacher said, that I'm totally on her side because she has no choice these days. And then, I liked how they got a quote from, this was the best part of the article. They got a quote from the curriculum. The curriculum's made, you know, however many, like, a few years ago for all these schools. Says, the problem set came from Eureka Math, a popular curriculum program that was created in 2013. So-and-so, director of marketing, who created it, told Today, the company uses both boy and girls' names in their problem sets and have never received this type of feedback. They do, however, take it seriously. That feels like such a, hey, it's, those are just random questions. Sometimes they say boys' names, sometimes girls' names, sometimes weight, sometimes height. It's just a math question. But Rhythm, she's changing the world, man. No, okay, no, I get it. I get it to some degree. That is a thing where, like, especially with females, young, impressionable girls, we got to be careful. But the question was just like three students. Their names are Isabel, Sue, and like Johnny, and we listed weights. It's like, how much heavier is Isabel than Johnny or something? Which, oh, wow, Isabel is a big girl. Wow. Okay, I'm kidding. I could be wrong. But I just thought that it reads like a fake article. Her name's Rhythm. It was a math quote, you know. But hey, I don't even know how does this like become news? Who picks this up? It's all over the place. But it did say she did end up doing the problem anyway and got it correct. So smart girl. But she also, let's just say she got a little off rhythm there. Rocked the boat, changing the stuff. So that's less triggered and more just funny to me. Anyways, Isabel's heavier than Johnny. But to be fair, in fourth grade, the girls are bigger than the boys. In fourth grade, the girls start to change. The boys haven't yet. I remember specifically getting beaten by arm wrestling by several girls in fourth grade. And it's not because I was little. It was because of puberty. Okay? Back then when I was in fourth grade, we were doing arm wrestling competitions with the boys and girls. And the girls were winning. Now that would be offensive. I was offended back then. It wasn't because I was little, dude. Hey, I'll arm wrestle a girl right now. I bet I could win. I bet I could be most. I thought that was funny. Yeah, appreciate y'all listening. I'm trying to think what we got coming up. Gonna go back on the road next year. We'll have some more info on that. Gonna do some shows. Okay. Be on the lookout. Be on the lookaloo. New merch is out. shop.treykennedy.com. New video's coming. If this is out, you probably just saw the new Office video. If you haven't, go check it out. I made a day in the office. Some of you are probably listening in the office. So hope that helps brighten your week a little bit. Thank you guys so much for listening. And do this. God bless, okay? Appreciate y'all. Much love. Talk to y'all next week. Have a good one. Peace. Correct opinion.